about pencil size, and I do this. And it opens.
Right. Phil Collins breakdown. You see what I'm talking about? Because that's Mike Tyson's favorite part of the song. All right. So when you do that, the door.
Side note: I believe that we are live streaming again. So sorry for the technical difficulties. Not a lot has happened. Quick recap.
Pizza was good.
Pizza was pretty delicious.
Runeheim here. This deep gnome.
Has that happened while you're gone.
No, has dimension doored into the area.
Apparently had a stroke too because he can't talk
anymore.
Teleported Dorian through some sort of alternate back to his reality.
Through time and space.
And Diz is now.
Diz and Dorian are no longer dimensionally challenged.
Right.
They're where they need to be.
Well, kind of. They're where they're supposed to be, not need to be.
Yeah, I feel sorry for the other dimension. Oh, wait, that's this one. Never mind.
What? Yep.
I said too much.
So as I do this, I lift this door open. A thought goes through my head that's maybe Natissa and the Pit Fiend, after they heard me say Everland, went there. And I'm trying to decide if I should go there. We should go there.
Is that before you open the door, or did you open this door?
I didn't open the door. I pulled out the sticks.
Okay.
As I do that, I'm actually going to look to Flint. I'm going to look to Titan and say, we should. Before we go in, we should talk to Flint. See what he found out with the deep now.
You mean the snurf nerve?
Yeah, the deep now.
This cat's trying to eat my thumb while it's attached to my hand. I'm still alive.
Nah, dude, you don't even need this, dude. You got two of them.
Watch out for him. He'll eat your face when you die.
I know, bro.
Cats all do that. They're crazy.
They're kind of
weird. I'm going to go talk to Flint. Flint, talk to me.
He's a good captain.
What did you find out? I suppose you and Danny need to have a conversation.
Yeah, we haven't done that yet. It's all right.
It's okay. I know you're having some
as he's coming up to me, I say, so you're the Flint.
What's my width? Where am I allowed to go to?
Right. Nope. There. A little more. There.
Here?
Right there.
Yeah, that's probably about as far as you can.
This way?
One more square?
There.
About another half is what you got.
Here-ish?
Right there is good.
That's there.
Yeah. That's perfect.
Okay.
And then you've got one more square this way, actually.
Alright.
Great.
Excuse me.
I have cue marks. I'm not even good for anything.
Alright. Thanks for the publicity, Noof. Appreciate it, man.
Yeah, thanks, Noof. I don't know what he's talking about. Thanks.
You need to mute the echoey thing.
Yes. What echoey thing?
You know what I'm talking about.
Like this one? Voice?
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
You have over here.
Good looking out, fellas. Looking out. I'm just an idiot. I'm walking blindly through this.
I'm sorry, what happened?
He had already this.
Yeah, I have red marks here. They should be accurate. But he lied to me about those red marks. That's what I said, don't
write. Well, I changed the way that the camera was looking before is what happened.
Maybe all that setup time. So you just change it on the fly.
All right, so I go up to
Runeheim.
And he says
way worse. And
he says keeps saying deep now.
You're the Flint that I heard of?
You didn't hear about me. I don't know what you heard about me.
I don't know what a Flint is.
But I'm
what?
What is a Flint?
What? It's a Flint.
Okay.
Do you start fires?
King of trees.
Dude, I'm about to start a fire in your face. I don't say that, Flint. Flint doesn't say that. No, Flint walks up and he goes.
Justice, clearly.
You guys, you'll have one chance to be honest.
I'm always honest.
Inside check.
Is he lying about lying?
Is he lying?
Not even good.
Oh, lie inception over here.
14 is all I got.
What I mean is I'm very bad at lying.
Which is enough to know, if he's being honest, that he's trying to tell you he's terrible at lying.
Okay.
So if he's lying, you feel confident. You'd be like, yeah, he's lying right now.
Wonderful. So then I say, explain in simple terms what has happened.
Well, there was an astronomical event of occurrences that came to this point.
In simple terms.
Oh.
As if to a child.
Okay. So.
Right in front of the mic. Oh, I'm sorry.
Chomping and roaring over here, man.
I go, alright. I was sent by my graders. I'm of an order called Order of Krazar. I'm Runeheim, by the way. You can call me Rune.
Okay.
You are?
Flint.
I thought you were Flint. Okay. Anyways, I'm here to be an assistance. Dorian didn't belong here, so we sent him back to where he belonged. And I'm the balance between, was it good and evil, or was it evil? I think it was good and evil.
What is displaced must be replaced.
Yes. So there's
like cheese for you. Oh, okay. And I buy this?
Does he buy this?
Okay. This is all true. I mean, I guess I could tell you. This is all true. You're not actually lying to me?
Yeah. This is great. Yeah.
You said by his graders. Are you lying?
Graders.
You for sure know. I can't lie. My charisma is in the toilet.
I'm actually super impressed with my on-the-spot art, because I'm a terrible artist.
What'd you got?
It's a cheese grater. It's a grater. Sent by his graders.
Oh, okay. It wasn't in the shop.
Oh, I know. I did that on purpose. I feel like nobody would actually appreciate it. I didn't expect it to turn out that well.
I thought it was some sort of tablet.
Oh.
I did too.
I instantly was like, that's a cheese.
Yeah, I thought it was some sort of lighting.
Like an apron with a lot of writing.
There would have been like 40 people.
Regardless. So Flint buys this. He goes...
Are you saying this in undercommon or regular?
Yeah, no, I'll initiate it in undercommon.
Because if it's undercommon, you can tell my undercommon sucks. I can understand you, but it's like gooder and
it's
not great.
Then I'll stop and I'll be like, where are you from?
The Underdark.
But you don't speak undercommon?
I don't remember it.
What happened?
They took my memory from me.
Who's they?
The Order.
The Order that you follow?
Yes. To become a perfect follower, I must forget.
Oh, dude, he got more devotion than you, bro!
Crap. Oh,
dude,
crap, yeah.
That'd put you to shame on the Order, dude.
But you can't hang with him in the Justice Department.
That's true. Dude. That's legit.
Yeah, dude. Oh, crap. So I'm like...
Not like the
Justice Department. Is this a choice that you made?
Like downtown, not that one.
I can't remember. But I know I have to be here.
We'll have a conversation with him about this later. Flint never forgets.
What?
Flint never forgets.
Catchphrase? Should we trademark this?
No. Flint never forgets. Not when it comes to justice. He doesn't forget about that.
Even in jam, he can't.
I do know that I'm doing a good thing for the balance of magic.
Okay. I respond with even a good thing against your will is a bad thing. We'll get to the bottom of that. But we have bigger fish to fry.
So to speak.
Yeah, if there's a giant fish in here, pass. Hard pass.
Oh, and also I introduced you to Blufo.
What?
My giant frog.
Who Titans
frog? My giant blue frog.
I don't like the frog.
Oh.
Titan makes up for your dislike with all of his like.
Yeah,
he's so enthusiastic about it.
Yeah, so when you say that, it's almost because it was just sitting there stationary. I didn't really notice it before, but now I'm like, oh, jeez. Let's just keep that away.
It's slimy and weird.
I just don't like it.
Look at the eyes. Look at its eyes.
I'm not afraid of it.
But keep it over there.
But, like, I just don't want it. I don't want it to gunk up my armor. Or something. Come on, let's go do something.
Okay.
Jeez.
And, I decide that I'm going to go ahead and open the door.
All right. So you do open the door.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, so we kind of gather back. I look around. Do I see...
That's a good conversation.
Do I see Shaw anywhere?
You see him walking towards the door he's about to open.
I join him.
I stand still. Away from the... Not dog. Sure what I'm supposed to do.
Okay. All right.
Have I attained the title of the Lifing of Konoha yet?
Absolutely not.
That's ridiculous, man.
Is it available?
Are you kidding me right now? No.
It's not?
No. Not even close.
This is ridiculous.
How much ridiculous do you think you could be?
I could.
Yeah. No.
Alright,
Kakashi would pull and say, "You're not my dad."
But your dad. I'm not gonna
shut
say
up. You're not my dad.
I didn't say
you're not even my real dad. Get out.
This makes sense.
Get out of my room.
This one makes sense.
I'm gonna go and open the... How does it open? Does it open straight up to the side?
Well, that's
down?
What I was gonna say, but then you didn't open it, so I didn't say that.
I know, but I am gonna do it now.
Okay. So, as you open it, it's just a large stone slab. That actually just slides straight out, and you can tell it's perfectly fit to this opening. Like that thing. But you can also tell, even with some age,
cool.
It's not making contact. It's a perfect fit. It slides straight
heavy.
Out, and
it's
after it's completely free, it just pivots in place.
So
there's an opening on either side of it.
So the opening is like 6 feet exactly, and this thing's like 5 feet, 11 inches... And like
it's,
99.
It's probably, no, it's probably about 5 foot wide door. You have decent, about a 6 inch thick ring around it.
Is this like a slip fit?
It just slides straight out.
Right.
Not touching the floor, not touching the sides, not touching the top, and then it just pivots.
So there's like a thousandth.
You have an opening each time.
So there's like a thousandth of play.
There's not really any play. Like this perfect craftsmanship. Obviously magical as well. You can tell the physical craftsmanship is also perfect. So.
Okay. So as I push it in, you said it's hinged?
You don't, when you cast it, you cast your magic, you use the magic, you don't do anything, it slides straight up towards you and pivots in the center until you're looking at two doorways on either side of it.
Okay, so it just says
so it just splits the opening. It turns, so the slab you're looking at is now an 8-inch thick slab, so you have a smaller doorway on both sides.
But right, so it just went like this.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep, so... I guess I'll draw that here, actually, to make more sense. So it comes out and it pivots something like that and it stays stationary. You have a small, not quite to scale, but you have an opening big enough for a person to walk through either side.
I'm going to walk through.
Okay.
There's an epic cramps about to happen.
Yeah, I'm also going to say.
Do a history check for me.
Me?
Yeah. Well, anybody can do a history check who wants to.
10.
For figuring.
I mean, you could. 10.
Okay. Anybody else want to do a history check as they walk in? Anybody else
do
it?
I'm standing back.
I do a history check specifically on the stonework.
Ooh.
With advantage because he's a graduate.
Oh, he's got a slide on that.
Yeah, I know, dude.
Kid, 17.
17 total?
That was good.
Yeah, I mean...
It slid right off that three, though. That was awesome.
Is there a thing that I'll probably add to that?
Your skill, if you have it.
Is this...
history?
History. Yeah, it's just 17.
Okay.
Survival, maybe.
You know the stonework on the outside is clearly dwarven?
If it's religious, I have 20.
The stonework on the outside is clearly dwarven? The inside of this tomb is not dwarven.
It's nerve nerveling thing, but I accent it.
It's magically crafted.
You're dead.
Interesting.
You're by human hands, most likely.
I explained this to my comrades.
I'm interested in it. What do you say?
I
believe that the outer area of this is crafted by dwarves. However, this inside stone is not of this world, at least not naturally. Magic in nature, probably by human.
I'll log that away because I'm interested in knowledge. So,
I'm listening, but I'm not moving.
I actually am going to ask him how I can tell.
Don't question me. Don't ever question me.
I'm petting Bluefoe.
No, I put my hand to the stone and I rub it and I was like, the texture's too perfect, even for as old as it is.
I feel it and make a mental note just so I can perhaps.
It's about a six.
Yeah.
I scratch it at the back of my fingernail. Should be a zero.
Should be a zero. Is your fingernail calibrated?
I'm a dwarf, dude.
That makes sense. That's legit. That's true.
Watch. Born calibrated. Zero.
This should be like glass. Now you called out a 16. A glass is a zero. Totally not what you're
talking about. You guys may not understand what we're talking about, but it's super hilarious. Yeah. Just trust us. Just laugh.
That's cool on an inside joke.
Anyway.
On the table, this amazing artwork is a picture of the statue of a sorcerer. Sorceress. On this table, it's a small statue.
Is she cute?
The statue.
She's
probably super dead. But anyway, she's kind of holding her hand up with kind of it kind of flaming. The other hand is holding a tome of some sort, and then kind
her
of
hands on fire.
Kind of around her, you see like some slaves and things, and basically to like attendant slaves, just other people, but they're all lower. And you know this symbolizes this was a person of great importance. That's why this statue was made of them.
Do I recognize who this is?
That's what your history check
is. Oh, okay, gotcha.
I'm not sure who this is.
I'm standing back.
But now that he brings your attention, you can do another history check for me if you would like to, with some of the other stuff here in the opening.
Nope.
Same thing? I'm close to?
10.
Talk ahead and I'm like, do you want me to stand here?
I will do another history check.
Seems familiar, but you don't necessarily know for sure, but the tapestry over on the other wall, wait, for sure. It's actually painted on the wall, and it's also preserved fairly well from where it is. But on the opposite wall from here, there's actually a large vista of cities floating in the clouds.
Yeah, good luck.
I'm just trying to roll it, because I don't like how this just like slides.
As it didn't slide here that time.
Yeah, as it didn't slide at all.
Yeah, I guess, but I like to roll it so that people can see it, which I also feel that.
I'm going to,
So, you see this painting on the other wall, it's a vistas of three different, kind of different heights, different size, but cities floating in the clouds.
I don't recognize it.
No, you, with a 10, you don't recognize necessarily what it is.
I mean, now I'm just going to walk in.
Do you want to do a history check? Anybody else?
I have the Lufo standing.
I got
you. I
shook my rattle.
You guys could use
the map. I did a history check. Pretending like I got a 4.
Yeah.
I got a 10.
I was just doing it for my own 10. Personal.
So
I got a 4.
Just keep me in the...
Okay, so yeah, you guys don't recognize anything additional either. Okay. You going to do a history check for me?
Me?
Yes.
Of course.
One thing I am going to say is... I think I might have heard someone down here. I think we should tread lightly.
17.
Could be someone in danger. Seems to be in distress.
Seems familiar, but you're still not quite sure necessarily who or what this is. But you.
I also make mention that it could be a trap.
I attempt to detect undead within 60 feet of myself.
Okay. Does it work? 60 feet. Is it just any direction, 60 feet?
Yeah.
Okay. Three.
Do you have to cast it, or does it just do it?
As soon as he says this, I'll concentrate. Again, I raise my left hand, and I kind of grip like the opening of my armor around my neck, which is my holy symbol for anyone that doesn't know. I grip that, and I hold out my hand, and this pulse wave just goes out, and I see if it returns with anything.
Something below you.
Oh.
You're not sure exactly how far, but there's definitely, it's within 60 feet, but you know it's mostly downward. And the only thing you see in this room other than the painting and that is stairs leading downward.
Sorry, my cape just moved you. It's strong.
It didn't move me.
Ironweave cloak over here.
Yeah.
It did not move me.
Wasn't Ironweave cloak a WoW thing?
I think so. So strong. Wasn't
the one that gave you defense stuff and Burning Crusade? Anyway.
Yeah, so I said tread extra lightly. There's the undead. I was going to say something different, but that's the best thing. I was going to say the unliving. I was like, that's dumb.
Super dead people over here. Dead.
They were once alive.
But
and they died.
But now...
earlier.
After the before.
Before
Merlin. Earlier and later, they're...
Before, after they...
Back to earlier.
Catch a niner?
Calling from a walkie-talkie.
This is horrible.
This is horrible.
Alright. So here we go downstairs.
These were amazing ideas.
I will go downstairs.
Well, you don't have to. I'm just preparing just in case.
Yeah.
Knowing that, one, that Flint deals in radiant damage.
I ain't scared of no dead as long as he's in front of me.
I ain't afraid of no ghost. Anybody see the new trailer?
I'm going to go...
I'm going to...
What is it?
New Ghostbusters.
New Ghostbusters.
I'm going to say, lead the one.
I will.
He's already doing it. Okay.
Don't tell me what to do.
Can Bluefoot fit in here?
No.
I do say stay close to me.
Probably.
Can he fit in here, Mike?
What?
Can he fit in here?
I mean, if Titan
How big is he?
Here.
He's a giant.
I'll get Flint like this.
He's a giant? Or he's a giant frog?
He's a giant frog. So I can ride him.
What size is he? Medium?
What are you?
Small. Awesome.
He's small.
Yeah, what's your size?
Wait,
you're
no,
tiny,
is it,
though.
Is it gnome?
Yeah,
is
I'm small.
Small.
I'm small.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Is the frog considered medium?
He's probably about the size of them.
Medium?
Yeah, so medium.
These guys are I'm saying, is he large or larger?
Huh?
Is he large or larger?
Let's find it.
Size chart.
I don't remember.
If he's large, he cannot fit. If he's medium, he can fit.
No way he's large.
That's what I was thinking.
No way.
Wait. It's in the player's handbook.
Oh, cool. Just messing my stuff
giant
up.
Frog.
Lance, sorry.
Yeah, so I have my shield and a hand axe out
on
at the moment.
When Flint says, stay close to me, Shaw looks at him like this. I thought he was.
He's not.
He's a frog.
I'm just saying. He's not going to say, stay close to me if you want a plus six in your saving throws.
Because that would seem weird.
That wouldn't make any sense.
Say what?
It's like you want to stay close to me.
Okay.
Do you give him on here or something? Weird.
As they come within 10 feet, they feel a slight wash of holy energy. Kind of.
What college did you go to, Mike? Let's go!
let's go!
Alright, exactly. So you walk down the stairs.
Yeah.
There it is.
Shield out only. I've got my hand on my hand axe.
Medium. He's a medium.
Just in case he needs to finish the fight.
He's a medium.
Alright. Deal. He can fit.
Cool.
You might also get one shot. With that.
Hey, if anybody's gonna get one shot, it's gonna be me. I'm in front.
I mean, it's probably...
I'm hoping
your
not.
Character's a lot harder to one-shot than a quarter challenge rating.
Yeah, it's going to be the guys that I'm hitting.
I tried to one-shot you, and you know what you did? You're like, resisted it.
Block, dead.
His charisma.
Undead. Oh, block!
My frog's, no, undead. I don't want
my frog's charisma that. Intelligence is awful.
Okay. Maybe that's why
okay, so here's what's going down.
Is your charisma?
Sorry.
That's true.
Yeah. We're going to go and walk through this place.
That's why we get along. We both don't understand each other.
Flint, I'm gonna go ahead and move you.
Yep, here we go.
Now, does this go down and then over? Or is this like
down and it goes around, and then that discontinues to here. So it's actually going back this way. This one's directly underneath that one. So see, it circles around, and then you come out this way. That makes sense. Okay. That's what that eye is for. That's one, just in case we need to do any other continuations for the camera, but I don't think I need to. I think it'll all fit.
Yeah, so far you guys are good. Fine.
Those rooms are kind of tiny.
What's that?
The rooms are kind of tiny.
I mean, dead people don't get up and move around a lot, so...
A lot, but like...
I'm saying you can only store, like, a couple dead people.
People were shorter back then.
Seems like it's just kind of inefficient.
And it is a dwarf tomb.
No. The outside is dwarven.
It could have been a dwarf tomb.
Were you there? I mean, Flint, no, if you were inside Flint,
it's not his thing.
He knows that it's magically crafted, most likely by human hands.
What? It could be a dwarf tomb.
It's like, don't care.
mostly dwarf.
Could be a dwarf.
Probably
some dwarf here. He's like, no, dude, it's a human tomb. Could be some dwarves though.
You know, pretty tiny.
Not been through it yet.
It'd be the perfect
size with dwarf friends.
Yeah. It would be the perfect size for some dwarves though.
See what I mean?
See, if I had some dead dwarves, this is where I'd put them.
Where's some fullings?
I feel like. Halfling? I feel like people. I feel like the fact that Titan is sort of oblivious makes Shaw laugh a lot.
Okay. I think we
not like he laughs out loud, but more
I think
like
we
he's talk like
about it before. Titan's attitude is kind of one of those things that like sustains Shaw.
It does. Yeah.
In
a
like
bit.
These underdog type situations.
Right, we've actually had that moment.
Yeah.
I was like, dude, this sucks. And Titan's like,
not bad. It's not that bad, really, though. We start thinking about it. When you start thinking about it, dude. Also, I brought some cheese. What do you think?
And think about the stories that are coming out of this place.
Just stories, man. Just pounds and pounds.
Granted, we're not going to come out looking like.
You can write. You can write in your thing, your booklet or whatever. All the stories, man.
Keep track of this. Write that down. I said that.
Remember?
All right. What do we got?
So, as you walk down. There's a description for the area you're now in. Oh, sorry about the earthquake, everybody. So, what happened? Okay, so as you walk into this room here, this is a shrine. There's shreds of just tapestries, dusty tapestries, lying all over the floor. So what level spell is the one you cast about the undead people?
It's not really a spell.
It's divine sense. That's what
I
thought.
That's why I didn't say anything. I just
one
sure.
thing I would like to do.
Alert all of the dead that were here.
No, dude.
There's...
I cast alert the dead.
On the wall.
Hey, you guys.
I think I'm saying it freezes on the wall. Like decoration type.
What? I'm sorry?
Paintings like friezes, like
Frieza?
Oh, crap. Frieza is like plural. Like
can you buy super
carving stuff? Paintings.
Yeah, sorry about that.
I'm thinking of the right thing. Google it for me.
Carvings are on the wall.
How do you spell
yeah,
it?
But there's it's F-R-I wait.
Frieze?
F-R-I-E-Z-E-S.
Frizes. It's a type of carpet too.
Frez.
Right.
It's frise.
It's frise.
No, it's frise.
That's what country you're from. All right.
Frise.
What is it?
A broad horizontal band of sculpted or painted decoration.
That's legit.
Especially on a wall.
I thought it was
because we have carpet.
I thought frise was
okay.
there.
Well, I was pretty sure it was solid and had some sort of texture. Okay, so that's what's in there.
I'm gonna call
these
Goku.
Things. These same things show the floating. The floating.
Yeah, he
thing.
Cast spirit bomb.
There's not enough living things to form it properly. Because you have to pull.
I'll teleport. I'll pull some teleportation.
Well,
triggers.
Outside of.
I'm all the life.
You
of
mean me. You're in a tomb?
I'm the life of this party.
So
see?
There's very little life
this.
In the
but
tomb.
I got
undead.
This.
Okay.
Yeah. See?
We'll be back next week with some more of that.
As
next week, I'll have a blonde wig on.
I'll have a blonde wig on. That's amazing.
And there's a and there's also a weird smell floating within his armor.
Okay. So anyway, so. Moving on, these things on the wall, they depict the same floating cities. This kind of goes around the upper parts of the room and everything. All of these have deep gouges and everything scraped in them, just randomly all over the room. And then this on this end, this is a marble altar. It's a pale gray marble. And it is also gouged and cracked. So something's had to hit it pretty hard and things have taken some chunks out of it.
Can I make some sort of a check to see what could have done this?
Yeah, you can do an investigation check, see what you find.
Real good. 22.
The damage is fairly recent. You can tell from that. And you can also tell it's kind of all over the room, and there are zero tracks in the dust on the floor except for yours. Your parties.
I ain't crazy on ghosts.
So something that did this was clearly strong, clearly big. Yes.
Didn't touch the floor. Also.
That's Ooh. What I'm getting at. So it's huge because it busted these things open.
Maybe it's
or
a wall climb.
Fly.
Couldn't really fit if it was huge. The hallways are. All
right. It large size,
five
big.
Feet wide.
It's
powerful.
Powerful. That's maybe the word. Strength wise.
I mean, you can. You could probably deduce.
But it's leaving. But it's leaving.
You can deduce that it's not a physical strength type thing.
Okay, that's what I'm getting at.
Anything that bears that kind of physical strength will leave tracks on the floor.
That makes sense. That's what I'm getting at. I'm gonna cast Detect Magic as a ritual.
I didn't know you left tracks on the floor, Titan.
Detecting it.
Okay.
Anything that powerful leaves tracks.
Detect magic?
Yes, sir.
All right. Roll percentile dice for me.
Whoa. Percentile. Percentiles.
Get rid of that ghost.
I detect magic.
It's going to make you blow up, dude.
Actually, now, let me ask you this. Before I roll these, can I transpose the numbers if I so choose?
Pose trans.
What do you mean?
Like, if I roll a 7 and a 4, can it be a 74 or a 47? Depending on what I choose.
Whichever way you tell it to me is the way it's going to be. The first
sweet,
one.
Bro. But you don't really know what's going
to
be good or bad.
I know. I'm just saying. I just want to know if I get to choose my fate.
I mean, I'm letting you roll for it, too. So.
All right, so we have 78 or 87. We got 87.
Yeah. 87.
You're dead.
Larger numbers always better.
As you try to cast this.
Well, it's not a prime. So. Neither one of them.
It definitely works.
Dude, roll a d4.
It fails.
4.
Your frog starts flying around the room.
I'm sorry, what?
The frog.
His frog starts flying around the room.
You know for sure that you just cast the fly spell on that frog. Not the kind that it eats.
What?
And you're not detecting that at all.
Flint, who's like guarding up Flint. Oh, no. Dude.
Yeah, dude, like the bat.
Come on.
What is that?
Get out of here.
I forgot I didn't like the frog.
Are you freaking kidding me?
I hop on.
Leave that thing outside.
I jump on.
Runeheim, get it down.
I mean, it's not like, dude. Oh. Blue Angels, like, stands here. It's like.
It's not, dude.
It's
barrel
like.
Roll.
But it was kind of looking around, and it's just like, that frog's up there now. It's like, now it's over there. It's more of a frog doesn't know how to fly, but it's flying.
Dude, this is weird.
So it's kind of just like, oh, that's weird. And it hits a wall. It's like, boom. And it like twitches, and when it does that, it's like, oh. And it's floating the other way. It's like that sort of thing.
It's no
not,
gravity.
Yeah, twitching.
Kind of, but yeah. It's just,
so here we go. Wild magic bros.
So.
That's amazing.
Starts swimming.
Yeah.
Do what? All right, so I didn't
know you could do that.
Man, this place is awesome. I'm glad I don't have to go back home. My frog can fly here.
Yeah.
So I know that I just cast detect magic, and I didn't detect any magic. In fact, I just cast fly on this thing.
You made magic.
Can I deduce what just happened?
There's a charm or something.
I mean, you know, your magic didn't work. Feels very similar to a couple different places you've experienced so far in your travels. So.
Where magic has been strange.
Yeah.
Not exactly.
Not working. Or, I guess, not so much not working. You know there was a ward in the slave pen that you were in. You couldn't use magic within the slave pen. But outside of there, weird things have happened. Mm. Mostly, like, you as you guys are traveling, like, you camped here, and you're like, I want to do this, and, like, that didn't work like it was supposed to, like that sort of thing.
Okay.
So, nothing this major before.
So, that was significant. So, that kind of...
Yeah. Because I don't think you can cast fly yet, technically. So. It's a spell.
Are you sure?
So, I mean, you might be able to.
I think I have the ability to, but I don't think I have it picked.
So, you haven't learned it is what I'm getting at.
Yeah, I don't have it.
So, that's what I'm saying. This is not a type of magic that you're...
I don't think I do.
Familiar with casting is what
if
I'm...
If I do, it's not ready. It's not prepared.
So...
I usually keep just about the same ones prepared most of the time.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. You know this is not a spell you were planning to cast or could even cast if you wanted to right now. If you're like, I'm purposely going to make that guy fly, you know you could do that right now.
Okay. Well,
that's interesting.
So. And I think Runeheim's touching
Yeah, things. I'm actually going to say...
Are you touching things?
I'm walking into that room looking around.
Magic has some strange effects in this place.
I don't actually go into the room.
Also, Flint, you know that your divine thing... wasn't affected at all when you did it.
Yeah, I'm even going to say, might be better to stick to melee.
Oh, yeah. I will do that.
To weapons.
I was going to do that.
Melee.
I'm going to cast the crap out of him.
I don't understand.
Well, he's really the only one that... Well, I guess him, too.
We got this, guys. It's okay. All right.
We'll so you're walking into the next room?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm walking up into it. I'm looking into it now.
Yeah, we'll go. I'll go to the next room.
Really quick, though, sure as you guys are walking through here, does anybody have any source of light? I guess that's an important thing because it is dark in here.
No,
I do have a source of light. I shoot the wall.
Is it super dark?
Yeah, it's dark. Like, you can still see because you have dark vision. Yeah. You can see because you have dark vision.
And be like, oh, I forgot. And then I shoot the wall with one of my arrows.
Which wall, specifically?
The one next to me. Just...
Okay, is it dim light or bright light?
It's light, the spell. I can't remember which one it
was. So that's bright light. Mm. Do you warn anybody first?
Within 30 feet.
Yeah.
And then 60
I didn't
feet.
Think about right. it. Like, but I didn't think about feet.
But.
Okay, so... you know you're doing it, so I'm not going to make it affect you the same, but Flint, your eyes are assaulted with bright light.
Cool.
From an arrow stuck on a wall.
Well, he's around the corner, isn't he?
No, you're in a hallway. He's saying
oh, I thought he was Titan. My bad.
And I'm blinded for 4 rounds.
Got him.
So, you see Flint all of a sudden. Ow.
Yeah, as soon as I go blind, I start backing up.
I turn around and I'm like, oh, I forgot you were... Gerber.
I'm yelling Dubish. Over the course Dubish, of this, and I Dubish. Say, arm yourself, something's happened.
Dubish, yeah. Whatever that was.
Easy, out. Flint.
You guys see the bright light immediately.
You just cast light.
Unless you specifically say something, I'm going to say that you guys aren't necessarily sure what's happening. Because he did just get out a bow and shoot at the wall.
Yeah.
That's why I was asking if you said anything first.
No, I just said, oh, I forgot. This might help. Because I remembered two of them at least needed light. The other one I forgot was a Druger beer.
He did have a stroke. All right. So you get the idea that he did something, and then you can kind of deduce from there that he cast a light spell somehow through that boat.
Yeah.
So.
No, Flint, it's just a light spell.
Okay. You guys press on, or are you kind of waiting for Flint to recover? You're not in combat, so, I mean, you're not going to...
Yeah, I definitely sit back and try
to
help
Flint.
If anybody touches me, I don't let them touch me.
Well, I mean, I'm trying to be like, you're just over here.
Back
into
the wall.
Oh, yep, sit.
Yeah, just sit there. Defensible position.
Just sit there. You'll be fine.
So,
great.
Just like over here.
Last character robs me and then lies about it. This next character immediately
blinds me and then tries to rob me and not lie about it.
So,
all right, so you recover.
I'm going to go ahead. Now that I can see, what's in this room? I know we saw the other stuff, but what's in this room? Because it was going to shed.
Four sarcophagus?
Not being
four sarcophagi?
Says, you know, it's okay. My eyes are sensitive to the light.
Yeah, I forgot you had my eyes.
And you see, on top of all of these, you see a human, presumably human, a humanoid human size on top of these sarcophagi. Just a repose position, but they're all just
Titan from back here says, are you sure it's not a dwarf?
It's slightly
this
large.
It looks.
It's a little bit different proportions than a dwarf.
I found
most
a dwarf.
Likely more like an elf or a human.
That's the Dugish booze.
Titan's like peeking up over the edge. Kind of dwarfy from here.
Yeah, it looks like he's got some stout legs. It's hard to tell.
Whatever.
What kind of dwarf is that?
What kind of dwarf is that?
Fat thighs. Right.
What was it? It was a what?
It's just hooded like figures that. Carved into the top of the stone, like this. Hood pulled up. Arms crossed over like that. Attendance, most likely, you can tell just from...
You're getting more of the...
Us and the table.
Us and the table.
Yeah, so basically, like, just from what you can tell, these were loyal followers or attendants or servants or something to the person whose tomb this most likely is. Probably the sorceress herself at the top. Anybody doing anything in there specifically?
Religion check.
Okay.
Once my eyes return. I have 11.
Religion?
Yeah.
Suspecting that this voice that I'm hearing could be somebody who perhaps died in a terrible way and has been raised as some sort of undead creature, I'm going to attempt to speak telepathically to the girl that spoke to me.
Okay. Anybody doing anything else in there?
Under my breath, I say, that's not one to save that bad. Clearly, trap.
Do you say clearly a trap out loud?
Yes, but you're going to have to make a perception check of 15 to hear me.
Definitely don't.
Okay. Titan, you can too, or Flint, or whoever. It doesn't really matter.
Sorry, what was it?
No.
What was the question? What was the comment?
Just make a perception check real quick.
What are you trying to perceive and where?
What I just said.
Are you guys still in that room perceiving things?
Yeah.
I am.
I had just said, that's not one of them saved that bad. Must be a trap. And then he said he wanted to know if he could hear it. I said it was under my breath, so make a DC 15 check.
Oh, I see.
But if you don't care to hear it, then it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, okay. If it's important, he'll say something about it.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and move around back over here.
Okay, so you just went there, kind of looked around and left?
Yeah, I really wasn't sure what was.
Okay.
You said it was some sort of... Wait, what did you say was in here? Humans?
Well, there
are they like
four,
in... Are they
four sarcophagus. Four sarcophagi.
That are open?
No. There are four closed sarcophagus with the carving of a person in death's repose with a hooded thing carved over them. Just a robed figure carved into the top.
Is that all that's in here?
And then on the floor there's a little... Basically just like a pipe, like a vent or something. I'm not sure what it is necessarily.
A pipe?
Yeah, it's something. It's capped off, but it has some holes on the side of it, and it's a couple, or about a foot tall or so. About 6 inches in diameter, and just stone fixture against the wall.
Okay.
So what Black Dot is. So.
Oh, okay. I am. Yeah. I'm going to come back in here and say... This seems to be a tomb. I don't know.
I look into this room now.
Okay.
I was getting some sort of telepathic impressions that said, save me. And it was a woman's voice. Must not have been... Then I'm actually going to full on say. Must not have been saved that bad. Seems like a trap.
I am going to use my Divine Sense again, but this time I'm going to try to specifically locate the source that I sensed before.
Okay.
So the first one was broad, and this one's more pinpoint?
Yeah. I mean, you're able to tell that it's coming from this direction. You don't sense... anything undead over this way.
Nothing there. Okay. That's the way that I'll walk then. I'll be like, I believe the source may be further in this way. Before I breach that threshold, I'm going to cast Bless on... Are you melee or... You're an archer.
I have melee. I'm going to say we should also investigate this just in case.
The big sarcophagus thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to just kind
of... If you guys are going to keep going, that's fine. I'm
just kind of under my breath, I'm going to cast Bless on me, Mike, and Lance.
Okay.
I see how they sleep the new guy out.
Yeah, I know the new guy.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. So who's going where?
Got to earn that crap, son.
Okay. So when you walk into this room, there's a black marble pedestal this sarcophagus is sitting up on.
It's much larger?
Much more ornate. It is larger. Over on this here is a stone piece actually carved into the wall on both sides. Bunch of little, basically, niches carved into it with canopic jars, which you could presume are organs, just different burial.
Sure. Rituals. Does this give me any indication as to who this could be? Like anything, any writings on the sarcophagus?
On top of this one, the entire top is actually covered in very, very ornate and what's the word on that?
Handwriting.
Not delicate.
Bedazzled.
Like very fine. What is the word I'm looking for?
Intricate?
Intricate, that's the one I'm looking for. Yeah. curtain. Yeah, so very dude. Colorful, intricate mosaic inlay across the whole top of this in color of floating cities depicted in the clouds again.
So again, can I discern who this is? Who this could be? This is a king of some kind? Any sort of like...
Well, you know from the statue upstairs, some sort of a sorceress or wizard.
Oh, this is the same person.
This is that. This is a shrine to that person.
Things called, where they
this is a tribute to that person up here, whose tomb this is.
Lich.
It seems so. Like from the Rossian period. Liches
be tricking.
Barbaros.
Yeah. It's a different style. There's no happy trees in this one. Happy trees are all down the hill.
This just says happy clouds.
Yeah, there are some happy clouds, so could have been influenced by it.
It's Mario.
Maybe.
The clouds are typically happy.
If I investigate the rest of the room, am I going to find anything?
What?
Do I need to?
The guy.
I mean, that's what you see.
Aside from.
It's the guy that floats around in the cloud.
I mean, that's all you see. There's nothing else in the room to see those niches. Like,
so there's like a there's like holograms floating above.
No, it's inlaid on the lid of the sarcophagus. This colorful picture with the mosaic tiles. I see what you're saying. Tiny mosaic tiles.
Gotcha. I thought you were saying it was like magic's like hologram kind of thing.
No, it's just inlaid.
It's colorful. Okay, it's colorful. Okay. I'm assuming this is what's making my, because there, well, there's, yeah, there's, this is a, definitely a some sort of sorcerer. So I'm not really sure what's going on. So I'm going to go ahead and open this too.
Okay. Titan, what are you doing?
Can you get a marker?
What color?
Is he doing a mic?
I'm
not accustomed to this.
I was just taking a closer look at the four sarcophagus with the carving.
Generally speaking.
Okay.
But.
Because I'm just kind of.
This
has to do with like looking at top of everything.
Yeah. I'm like kind of doing one of these where I put my hands on it.
So. Right. So. This kind of happens sort of at the same time. So. Shaw.
Because this guy's like totally into. No, I'm sorry.
You said you were going to try to open this one up?
Yes.
Right? Okay, so Titan's over in the other room. I assume Flint was kind of there with him.
For the viewers, I've also included Danny within my bless spell. Because cool. I can do that if I cast his level too. I didn't realize.
All right. So, as you touch this...
What about Rune? He needs to be in it, so... Not just me.
Oh, yeah, I can do that. I cast it on Rune instead of Danny.
No, he cast it twice on him, once on me, once on Lance.
I'm double blessed. Not that guy.
Forget this guy.
I actually trick Lance to think that he's being blessed. I go, whoa, whoa, whoa. But then I actually bless myself three times.
He's like, yeah.
Oh, blessed.
Blessing.
All right. So,
right.
Soon
we'll
as
just
you, if you want
to dude, what's open, awesome, what's awesome is Tight would be like,
dude, I feel it.
So
I feel
good.
It, dude.
I feel so good. Look at this. Look how strong I am. I'm huge.
Do a strength check if you want to try to open the sarcophagus.
With advantage?
Sure. I mean, are you going to help him or are you just watching him? Or...
Yeah, I'll help.
So.
Well, yeah, Titan and I are in the room. That's...
I rolled a 19, so 17.
That's nuts. Very nice.
Yikes.
But no.
You're
Shaw,
a negative 2 to your strength.
So as he's getting
it's
ready.
Holy
so
crap.
So
it's
as
bad.
He's getting ready to come up and start helping you. So as he's getting ready to come start helping you, you start to push on it, you know, expecting, you know, the stone lid, and as you start pushing on it, you realize there's magic keeping
surprise
the lid, keeping the lid from being as heavy as it should be, so you're able to slide it.
Oh,
so it's not quite hovering, but it's reducing the weight, and you know.
Do I feel? Do I feel?
It feels
well.
Buoyant.
Not feel? Quite. Just like when you know how heavy a stone is supposed to be, you like bear into it. You're just like.
Do I sense this as well?
That's not right.
Okay.
So by the time you get up there, you're just...
I'm
you're
stronger
probably,
than I thought.
Well, no, you're probably more like, man, this wizard's super strong, because he's just like...
Yeah.
By the time you get there,
you guys
he's like,
make
wow.
That sound as you try to move that. I look over to Titan, and I go, did you just hear a girl?
I was pushing this. I don't know what he was doing.
If I hear it, I'm going to say, it's this Runeheim guy.
So what you do hear, though...
Weird.
What you do hear in the other room as well, an echoing, a voice that's echoing, booming, comes out of there, says, you've disturbed the tomb of Briseis of Kame. Accursed are you, most miserable of creatures. And then
it was him.
I go, you must not read from the book.
it was him.
The mummy? Anybody?
No. I'm just
kidding. I read from the book.
I can't lie.
You two make a charisma saving throw who are in the room.
Oh, no. That's my weakness.
Oh.
Well, really? Your strength's not your weakness? Negative two?
Holy.
He has a negative four.
Ooh. What?
Danny.
Did you say negative four?
No, that was a lie.
Okay.
12.
See full total?
Yeah. It was a 13, not 18.
Yeah, not go 13. 18. Yeah. How's a 10 look?
Actually, you guys are both blessed, so you can add a d4 to your saving throw if you would like.
I would definitely love to.
You're not within 10 feet of me. Wait.
Here we are.
No, you're not.
I am.
If you were, you
My
would,
frog is, so I
Your
am.
Frog is not charmed then.
Cool.
So what's yours total? 15?
No, 12.
I thought you had 12 with your use it thing.
The bless.
And then you added 3 to it. I thought you already had 12. 15?
Oh, if I add the bless, then...
Yeah, you add it to your roll.
Yeah, 15.
So what is yours?
10.
Do I want to use my inspiration?
No, I don't. Your bless is not...
It just happens?
Anytime.
So no matter what.
If you make a d20 roll, you can add a d4 to it as long as you're blessed.
Any attack or...
12.
Are you going to stick with that?
I think I'm staying with it.
Okay, you save. You do not save.
Okay.
Disadvantage on attack rolls and saving throws for the next 24 hours.
That hurts.
It's a curse.
Are you alright?
Yeah, it is an effective curse.
I ask him, are you alright?
I think Shaw will let out a curse of his own after he gets hit with that.
Beep.
Okay.
So now you're discussing them and
cursing
them?
As this thing is open
Shut
now,
up.
Within inside rude. Of it is a inside of it is a life-size statue of Briseis.
Do I know that this has happened?
I mean that.
Am I aware?
That voice.
You kind of hit.
Oh, the curse?
Yeah, I guess.
You know something's happened. Something feels off.
Okay.
So.
I feel great.
So inside there's a life-size statue of Briseis, sculpted and painted to make it appear that she's sleeping comfortably. And then the statue is affixed to the inside of the sarcophagus. And that's it. Just a painted life-size statue of Briseis.
In here?
Inside of it.
In our room, I go...
At the same time. Hang on, at the same time, because that's what I was saying. So that's, mm-hmm. that's what happens in your room. At the same time, you hear a screech, kind of a squeal screech.
You did hear it.
Probably like a screech, we're going to go with.
Are you making fun of me?
Kind of. Yes, a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Funny move.
Inspiration, you don't make fun
of me. I guess more of a howling. I'm going to go with howling.
Yeah, that's right.
As you do that, as you see that, a specter.
Oh.
Comes up, floats up right in front of you through the lid of the sarcophagus right in front of you.
I'm like,
And Flint, you notice where you're standing that three more come out of the other three that he's not looking at. So there's four.
I ready my weapon.
He takes a
kind of float up through them, all of them howling, seemingly in agony and or fury.
Like, was that a spell effect?
Which one?
The one that I got hit with.
Yeah.
Something? What was it called?
It was a curse.
The curse of
Bob
Saget.
Bob Saget.
What are you doing?
I don't know. It's getting late, Jim.
I can tell, man.
You're getting
weird.
So, at that point, roll initiative.
Good thing initiative is one of the best things.
That's a 6. I'm sorry. I can't
Plus two.
What did I get? 17?
What?
So since I'm short like a halfling, do I get halfling luck as well? I didn't roll a 1.
No, because you're not that short.
You're not lucky.
5.
Let's see.
Still pretty good.
Yeah, I got an
8.
Mike's already doing this to me.
I asked you if you were going to stick with that or not. Did I not ask him?
He
did.
He gave you the chance.
He gave you the DM ultimatum.
Which means, if ever he has that question, go for it.
I'm just saying it may be worth your your inspiration if I ask that question.
All I'm saying is, like, I think I might be able to get rid of it.
17.
But
you know it's a curse, so
I know.
You're rid of it. I can't. 24 hours.
I'll have to look at that. I may be able to cure you from a curse.
I think this can.
I think it would.
I think it does.
17 total. I'm sorry.
I mean, the reading of it does. If Flint has something that is like definitely will do it.
I don't know for sure.
You have the whole paladin spell list. Did you know that?
Yeah. You're only limited by spell slots. You know all the spells automatically each level. Only wizards have to learn the spells.
Yeah.
And because they get access to more spells than everybody.
Eldritch Knights, too.
Because they use wizard spells.
Don't paladin
still have. They're a wizard. Fighter, yeah.
That's why I almost went to death ranger.
But in the end, I was like,
okay. What did you two get? Shaw, did you roll initiative yet?
Or I have not.
And becoming a human machine gun sounds amazing.
I'm actually going to ask you a question real quick. See if I could do it.
Oh, forgot. What are you trying to do?
Well, it's gonna take. If I can even do it, it's going to take my best spell slot, so...
What's your dex, Flint?
Oh, mine's 0.
Okay.
My modifier is 0.
Like, it's an actual 0. He can't move. He's immovable.
Yeah. Frozen gun. My score is 10. My save is +3.
Like a baller.
That would do it.
Would my save been higher?
If you were within 10 feet of me.
Dang it. How much higher?
+3.
Dude,
you could have saved your own life. What did I say?
Potentially.
What did I say when we came down here that you made fun of me for?
What?
Stay close to me.
You did. You kind of
and
like...
You had to make a gay joke and go...
I didn't make...
No.
Sean didn't make no gay joke.
You made a gay joke and then went into another freaking room and now you're complaining that I couldn't help you.
Just thought you'd be on my team.
Well, just didn't think maybe you were just as racist as you were.
He's the biggest racist on the team.
That's a fact. True.
All right, shall we wait for your initiative? I assume you're going to be at the top, so I just left that spot open for you.
Probably not.
I wrote all that out.
15?
It almost.
Everybody back up into the hall.
Quickly.
Go, please.
To the hallway.
I'd like to, real quick, can I dispel magic?
That would not work on this particular effect, because it's a curse specifically.
This is a magical effect, and I asked you if it was a magical effect. You said
I mean, it is magical. The only reason I'm saying that, it gives me a specific way to get rid of it, and that's not the way. There's two specific ways to get rid of it, and that's not what it gives me.
Okay.
Yeah.
True love's first kiss, obviously.
I didn't.
I mean,
but then again, you just made that wall of rocks between you and your true love, so you guys are still in the playground love sort of phase. Mm. So you push each other off the monkey.
Okay, I mean, Bluefoe is here for you to kiss if you need it. So. I mean, he might turn into a prince or a princess. Who knows?
You got curves, dude.
Which is a magical effect that I can't dispel for some reason, which is interesting.
Oh, can I? Would Bluefoe just go on my turn?
I get it. I want to dispel with magic.
What happened? Will Bluefoe go on my turn?
Hammer time.
I've never seen you roll his own initiative.
He would act on your turn. Also, be careful.
For the next 24 hours, Shaw also hears, "Return this love."
Maybe. And in a less magical way, he hears Flint go, "Told you."
Yes.
Yeah, I told you.
Because he's standing right next to you.
Yeah, man. I told you, man.
I plan to upgrade him, if you're concerned.
Not. Here's the thing. I'm not, like, super concerned. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not, like,
so terrible. The crap out of
make it rain, play it. Make it
rain. Dude, I watched that video the other day, dude, when they're like, make the rain thing.
Which is awesome, too, by the way.
So fine.
Make it rain.
Sorry, I'm gonna look this up.
Magic whistle.
What time do we have right now?
9:26.
Alright, that'll do.
It's true.
If you don't want to do it, Mike, it's not a big deal. Let's go.
Okay.
We can move on.
Yeah, I'm going to say no with that particular spell just because it doesn't. It lists two specific ways and that's not.
Yeah, it says restoration and some other thing.
Yep.
Okay. Which is whatever.
All right. So, at this point, these should have been. I don't know about that.
Let's see what I got for you.
It's restoration and waiting for 24 hours.
Nothing that can help. There you go.
I'll just wait 24 hours.
I'll do that. I'll cast that right on you.
That help? Yeah, the other one that's probably a curse.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to talk her way out of this fight.
Cast that right on you. Does that help?
No. Yeah. On what?
Huh?
It was disadvantage on what? On saving throws?
And attacks.
And attacks.
Slip him right out.
Damn, you're insane.
Runeheim's insane. I'm just.
That's what it's all about, dude.
Bread and butter.
Butter and bread.
Either one is good.
Or bread and jam.
If you have that, see? Yeah. I just imagine them, like those two having like side conversations, like bread and butter. Or butter and bread. Or jam if you have it. That's really good too.
Cheese, really good. I like cheese whiz. Did you say cheese whiz?
Post hard cheese.
Yes, we would like to remind everybody that this podcast is brought to you by Post Hard Cheese.
The best hard cheese in all of the land.
There's nothing small about the taste.
Runeheim approved.
Wait a minute.
Runeheim hasn't had it. He can't say that
That's
yet.
That's true.
Okay.
You definitely get in on this advertisement. On average, times you stick together.
What? You're in no danger.
What are you talking about?
How strong you are.
Yeah, but you will get.
Because it's above average? It's on average?
You've got.
I think.
My, if you're within 10 feet of me, you gain +3 automatically.
Me being.
Static.
Short.
So I seem to roll like 2 18s.
Can you save against this curse?
No, it's just like a blind
strength. He can in 24 actually. Hours.
Just because it makes my
he might, so you much could fail it in 24 hours?
No, it sucks.
Like at the 24-hour mark, you have to save against it?
No.
Be cursed again?
Yes, that's how this one works.
Oh, it is.
This particular one, you save again after 24 hours.
Oh, I thought it was like you were done.
Or there's two other ways. Like I said, very specific ways for it to stop.
Great.
Do you know those ways? Can you research those?
I mean, I can.
He won't know them at this point. All right.
I can.
So.
If the information's in a book, then you know it.
Titan.
I'm like omniscient with that.
This guy here, which one were you looking at? Just so I know.
As the way my character's looking.
Okay. So the one behind you here.
Behind you.
Swings some creepy spectral claws at you for a 17 against AC.
Matches, so nope.
Nice.
Oh, dollar bill.
Go ahead and cash in.
I cast. See behind me.
I cast. What was that?
Yeah. I feel like as it's coming, as the one's coming up out of the sarcophagus,
do your one.
I suddenly think about, wait, there were three other in the room. And I turn right as the guy's swiping. And I like.
Yeah, and then right as you see that one, you see the blue one over here in this corner.
Yeah.
Same deal.
He's insane, dude.
So he's the same thing. He misses horribly. Halfling one over here. So he swings at you.
Or gnome too.
And
these ignorant guys.
He kind of floats out here.
Titan just keeps spinning in the circle. Like, hey, what are you doing? Hey, quit it.
He's
making me mad.
Flint, you see stuff swiping at Titan.
That's my
spectral turn? Things, yep.
I'm almost like, oh crap, I'm aware of this fight.
Also,
before
were you,
it's already gone.
Were you here or here?
I was in, it's kind of in the middle, but I realized there's only two squares. So,
yeah, so.
I will be here.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, so no big deal.
This guy, I was just moving him kind of the center. There's only two squares there. Yeah, so.
Inflict wounds.
Where is this? In Celestial, I speak an ancient prayer that is basically, I just say, St. Cuthbert, guide this blade. And.
What happens?
He brings it. We'll lose a spell slot, but now this my hand axe becomes a magic weapon.
That's a terrible spell effect. You lose a spell slot.
Yeah,
why did I cast that?
I lose a spell slot. Now, my blade is considered a magic weapon. Nope.
Wasn't it magic?
My hammer is, not my hand axe.
Hammer time.
Got it. Hand axe of destiny. Yeah.
But it now deals...
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Radiant damage? Warlocks, hunters...
Is it all radiant damage or adds extra radiant damage?
Oh, yeah, dude.
What's going down?
It now deals
2d8. No. It's just because they're undead.
Oh.
It gains a 2d8 damage to
baller status. Let's roll.
So additional 2d8?
Yeah.
So it's a d6 plus 2d8 radiant? Or all radiant?
It's a d6 plus 4 plus 2d8.
And how much of that is radiant?
Two of it.
2d8?
Okay.
Will be radiant.
So just make sure you keep those separate for me. If you're attacking.
I think that's the one, right? The other one, hang on, maybe I'm doing this wrong. Didn't it give... How did I add an attack bonus last time? Remember that?
It's you're proficient with this, you'll get your proficiency bonus plus strength on the hand axe.
Yeah.
It's like free.
So it should be the same as your hammer as far as that stuff.
But I did it. Maybe it's a different spell.
Like you can get wings.
I think you were.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
I don't know. I don't know how I did it. Anyway, I'm going to try to hit the...
You did the armor, the shield of faith last time. Yeah, right. I don't think you had a weapon here, I think.
Yeah, but I did something that gave me
it's the best
bonus. I don't know. It doesn't matter.
Okay.
I'll figure it out.
I have
it later. So I'm going to swing first one on my right. I'm going to swing down.
Clear guy.
Yeah. So 15.
That'll hit.
No. Wait, what is it? It's 6. 7. 13.
That'll hit.
Cool.
This is like tipped arrows and stuff too.
I need a D8. So my 8 is 10 radiant.
Oh, correct.
5 radiant magical damage.
No, you don't want that.
Okay, hang on a second. So,
if they're vulnerable, they're taking 20.
Okay, so I'm saying how much of what?
I've got 10 radiant damage.
Okay.
And 9 just magic damage.
Just regular?
Like a magic weapon.
It's magic.
Just regular.
Yeah.
Okay, but what type is it?
Slashing.
Piercing, slashing?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's magical.
Right? Yeah, that's fine. I just want to be clear.
It means it didn't work. Just kidding.
That would be ridiculous, dude. Okay. So... When you hit this first one with that, you see it kind of shimmer for a second, glow, starts to dissipate, then actually it kind of floats down and brings itself back into the sarcophagus where it's supposed to be. Kinda,
cool.
You see it fade back inside of it.
After I do that, I then turn and slash at the one on my left.
Nice.
Oh, you know what? I forgot to add another d4 to that. So that's 8 magic damage to the second
8 radiant.
8 radiant damage, I'm sorry.
Okay.
And, same amount, 9 magic damage to the second guy.
Okay, same effect.
Excellent.
Yeah, this is like your fight.
No, it's not fighting.
Undead dudes.
Feels good.
Anything else?
That's all I got.
Alright, Shaw.
I'm gonna do some more investigation after I get this lid off. And they're already in the other room.
Yeah. And you're some trapping? You're some fighting?
Right.
You already heard the trapping. I felt it.
Yeah.
And then you heard the fighting.
Is there anything in here that would be worthwhile for me to have gotten cursed for? That's what I'm looking for.
Secret weapon. That's what it was.
You disturbed a tomb.
Right. I mean, the thing in the tomb?
It's the statue
painted? Is there anything on it? Like, cool?
It's
like
a painted statue.
No gems?
The most intricate or valuable thing possibly in this room would be the lid of the sarcophagus with the mosaic inlay on it. But obviously it's a very heavy lid.
Hmm, okay.
But not as heavy as it should be.
Yes.
I'm gonna smash some of these vials.
Shriveled organs fall out.
Good. I might pee on them. I'm just kidding.
Well, that escalated quickly.
I'm just kidding. I poop
desecration.
On them. I'm just kidding. I don't pee on them. I poop on them.
Full on Krug move.
Just kidding.
I'm sorry. That was a Krug. It was a Krug. It came out for a second. My true D&D character is a half-court barbarian that has no cares about anything.
Who breaks bows and poops on people through roofs.
And gets possessed.
And has to use the bow.
And then has to use
it. The unarmed elf.
Yeah.
Click. Ah, dang it.
I did too. I also like that I was like
justice.
I scale the wall.
Yeah, there is a door at the bottom. Keep this in mind. It's like, you can walk in the door. Climb the wall.
So do what?
The entire
straight to the 70 boss foot tower. Yep, that sounds good.
Yeah, that's what I'll do.
You have to roll pretty high. 20, 20, oh, and 20.
Yeah, he was totally alone when he got into that boss fight.
We, on the other hand, were accidentally summoning.
I kicked the door
some
down.
Sort of beholder,
I remember that.
That's
a grick or something.
Anyway, back to what we're doing.
Rabbit Dragon 40.
Dude, I'm addicted to these. These are addicting.
Dude, they're so
good. Cancer?
Was it
no. I've been mad.
There was a 72 or something. We tried to break it. We're like, let's get out of here. That didn't happen.
Here's what sucks. Before we had any technical difficulties, we were up to 6 viewers. Now it's just Noof. Not that we don't like that. We're glad
you're here. Yeah, we appreciate you being here, Noof. That's not what he's saying.
It makes us feel good. It just.
But the internet broke our viewership today.
Yeah. Like, oh, we're on a roll.
Nope. You down.
Into a mud puddle.
On
a bike.
You know what I'm talking about.
And if you've ever done that, you know what that means. It means you think you come out on the other side okay, but you have that poop stripe up your back. That's what that means.
We're all flipped up.
Ouch.
All right.
I'm going to move into this room. What is this, this marble shrine?
Cracked and gouged. And
is it to a god or something? Or what is it? Who's it to?
This sorcerer, as far as you can tell. Oh, do another history check for me.
So
with advantage this time. I'm going to have you this turn.
I'm just having a hard time understanding why, like, a sorceress wards a tomb that contains nothing.
And then calls us down here.
Yeah, I guess I'm not falling.
Oh, there's something in here, dude.
Well, good thing I have advantage. Whew! Barely. 15.
Okay. It's kind of starting to make sense to you. You kind of recall something you might have read at some point about
books, dude.
About a kingdom. this is going to be, I don't remember how long it was now. It's going to be a considerable time ago that this kingdom existed.
Does it start with an N?
But it does.
I know what it is.
So, yes, you do. I figured you would.
Yeah.
I'm saying.
I knew it as soon as you started talking.
Shaw kind of remembers, kind of is like, yeah, there was this. And you kind of have to, like, something, you know, starts with a K. You know, there's this guy. It just won't quite come to you. There's this guy
who comes to me.
Yeah, but it doesn't come to Shaw. You're like, there was a whole thing with floating cities, and then it
fell to the ground.
Really hard.
Because somebody was like this. Dude, no, I can be a god.
I got this.
Oh, no, I can't.
I got this.
Whoops.
I didn't got that. So, you kind of just start piecing stuff together like, yeah, this is an ancient civilization. You're still not sure why this is in the Underdark, though. So, just that was kind of triggered by her proclaiming with the magic mouth spell that it was Rhesus of Cain. They're just like, that seems familiar.
Okay.
So, But anyway, you can continue doing what you're doing. But yeah, this is this person obviously thought very highly of themselves. They were a very important person, wherever they were. So,
you can put your handbook.
Yeah, why don't you go with this one?
This is fine.
I'm gonna use the rest of my turn to. Does this shrine have any sort of compartments or anything? No?
Solid stone. You can tell because it's cracked, it's solid. It was solid stone.
Okay.
Don't worry about it, dude. We'll worry about the demons things.
I mean, he's pretty much got it handled over there. Hey, go to sleep. Shut up.
Why don't you just go to the astral plane or something, I guess?
Wow.
He's still bitter about that whole thing.
No.
He's not even the one I don't want in the Underdark alone.
I won't counterspell next time.
What sense is cool. Like, douche? Make no one understand. No, he didn't.
Yeah, I fully don't understand what happened. I hate you for that.
I'll let you get insect swarm next time. I cast insect swarm. No, I'm just kidding. Just kidding.
I think it is getting late. I can feel it. I can feel it coming on.
Yeah, go ahead. Move on. I'm done.
Are you gonna do anything else?
No.
Okay. Yeah, the next one. Wait for it. Titan.
Right.
Wait. No, he killed Blue. Sorry, it's not quite your turn yet. You're on deck, though. But the good news is, this guy tries to hit you. He doesn't hit you.
He doesn't hit me. The die hit me.
No, he doesn't hit you.
The die didn't hit you. Like a boulder.
So you felt the wind rush on your back, and you're like, whoa, another guy, seriously? Whoa. So the third one.
How many of them are you?
Third one takes a swipe at you, and then he doesn't hit you. Now it's your turn.
All right,
do it.
So at this point,
Tommy, you have no regard for their lives.
I'm gonna be like,
you guys are dead.
So awesome.
You picked a bad time to wake up, guys. Yeah.
You guys are dead.
Yeah, we know that already.
We're gonna, I'm gonna return into where you know. So I'm just gonna swing at red over there.
Okay.
What you got, dude? 22.
That will hit. Holy
sucks. I mean, I guess if we get like
Plus 7.
Yeah, if we get like huge
16.
What's it do?
16.
16 damage?
Yep.
That's helpful.
All right.
Bludgeoning.
Or no, they have to flee as far as they
okay.
can.
Okay, go ahead.
That's good.
And then...
You're starting to say 16, right?
That's a good double move.
For up to a minute.
Dude, that's actually not so bad. If we fought a bunch of them.
16 and you hit red?
Yep.
Go.
Okay.
Go ahead. And then I'm going to make another attack. All
right.
Does it hit?
No.
What's
does
total?
It hit?
12. Wait.
Oh, you got one?
You also have your bless.
13.
Oh, you actually hit with 12. These guys are...
Oh, okay.
They're not wearing any armor or skin or anything solid.
Awesome. That means I can't miss. Unless I do two ones.
Yeah, he has to double one to miss them.
Double one to miss these guys? I love it.
Yeah. I mean, they're pretty weak. They're just like... Hey, we're serving stuff.
12.
All right.
What?
I love it.
This one.
What did I say?
unlike the other two, this one kind of shrieks in a different, like a higher pitched tone, and it kind of. I'm trying to remember the reference I'm thinking of, but it kind of just blasts apart in like dark, like particles. Like it, the light fades from it, and blasts apart. It doesn't go down like the other ones did that he hit. But nevertheless, it is gone.
I think
I have a hunch. I have a hunch that I'm going to use on my turn. Hunch.
Yeah. All right. Anything else, Titan?
Nope.
Runeheim.
It's mine.
The Runeheim. Yes.
So, as he's standing there, I see
a ghost in the corner? Has this one taken hits yet?
No.
No. There's definitely a specter floating in the corner, though.
Yeah, more.
All right, with my bow, I'm just gonna plug two arrows into it. Just like.
All right.
Coming from both sides, like, of Flint. Kind of
Flint
like
loves that sort of thing. You should definitely keep doing the showmanship thing with arrows around his head.
Yeah.
He's super into it.
He probably didn't even notice. Wham. That's not good. I don't remember.
That'll hit.
Tell you what, if one of us was a plastic
girl, that's my shit.
Should I wear my tank top next week?
7, 13.
13 damage.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Hey guys. I'm gonna play some games. All right, go again.
Second arrow.
19.
19 will hit.
Max damage.
4.
14.
This one, same deal. When you hit him, blast apart. Light fades immediately, blast apart.
Hey guys, I'm a man. Let's play some games. That's amazing.
Alright.
I'm sorry.
Alright, so the specters seem to be gone. Flint and Titan, give me a perception check.
Also, I went back and looked through my divine sense. If any undead or fiend is within 60 feet of me, I automatically can sense them, like a pungent odor.
17.
And I have to.
So that's
something
you don't do.
Right. I have to specifically use the ability to pinpoint where they are.
Yeah. Well, you know, there's still another one within.
He's saying like for next time,
60
right.
feet of you.
Yeah.
It's just an always-on thing, and then the pinpoint is when you use the actual like.
That's a good idea. But that is automatic. It's a passive thing that you.
It's just kind of a passive thing, yeah. So that like when you enter or when something enters your presence that is like, you know, that's evil like that, then I can sense it smells like.
Also, on my turn, I do this.
Butt. But then when I inversely, okay. When something holy or celestial or something comes in, it smells like a sweet smell, sort of a thing.
So if it's undead, it smells like a stinky old yeah, butt.
An angel. She smells nice.
Ooh.
Stinky old butt. All
right. Perception check, Flint. What did you get total?
17.
11. Perception, you said?
I'm too focused on the battle.
It's a battle. Perception.
To pay attention.
Did you say perception?
Yeah, but not you.
Oh, man.
You can't see from where you're at.
I really do. I can see
it. Stinky
can't see
I'm looking between his legs.
You can't
we got
see
this pile
yeah.
over here. Can I hear it?
Titan, right where you're looking, that sarcophagus is on stone rollers.
Sweet.
What?
I'm gonna move it.
Oh. I get out of the way as he starts to do this because he's like pushing
rolls
it.
Out. Oh. This way.
And there was an earthquake as I did it.
Yep.
Yeah, so it rolls out this way. And yep. then, do a strength check for me, see if you can move it.
I'll do one.
You're still the other.
Oh. You better let me handle it.
Yep, that moves it.
Negative 2.
Plus 5, 17. 8
hurts.
Alright, you move it easier. Then you can look down directly below this chamber. There's a 4-foot hole in the floor. And you see another chamber similarly sized, but it's pretty dark. The light's not really getting down there as much because of the angle.
Really?
I put my axe up and my shield up. I grab out Abigail, and I say, "Watch your eyes," and then I cast Sacred Weapon on it.
Watch my eyes.
She emits bright light within 20 feet.
I'm doing this.
So I close my eyes as I do it.
Any
bright light within 20 feet.
I'm doing this.
Ah! Yeah, I die.
I say it's slightly quieter.
Should
have peeked. Guys,
everyone.
Watch your eyes. And then I go like this.
Don't tell the neighbor. Justice.
Alright. You guys, peek in there, or what do you do?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Hey, you didn't know about it yet.
I heard it. I could hear it.
He didn't know about it yet. I go, "Hey, we found a hole. You're not in here yet, but you should come."
You should come in here. Let's go.
Okay. You see a majestic sphinx.
Perched. Yeah, I want to go down the hole.
No.
Not really. Not yet. I wish.
I was like, no.
As I'm heading in there, I look to Sean.
Don't come in here.
Are you staying?
Don't come in here. Tell our stories.
Excuse me.
I say, don't come in here, Titan. Tell our stories.
All right.
I asked Joe if he's staying, and if I do, I was like, if you do, if you need assistance, Blufo, just tell him.
Click, click.
Yeah, just get right
and then
on.
I walk away.
Okay.
Squish, squish.
Click, click. Squeak, squeaker. Squeak, squeaker.
Squeak, squeaker, squeakers.
All right. So, who's going first?
Me?
Yeah, probably you.
Yeah, I'll go first.
Because
I don't
want to
drop on top of
me.
Yeah.
I'll go right
I'll drop
after.
In there.
Okay.
With my athletics.
As soon as you drop in there, there's a wraith directly in front of you.
Oh, yeah.
I don't drop. I, like, swoop down and...
And she's standing in front of another sarcophagus that's on a wall, very ornately inlaid with gold, a few different things. Also murals adorning this room of floating cities. And,
sound familiar?
And she says, finally, you've come to free me. And that's in your head also. It's telepathic.
As I drop down, I'm hanging from the
hang
ceiling.
Hang on. No, I say holes. Hands. As soon as I drop down and see this, I say, hold. Don't come in here yet.
I hang from the ceiling.
Yeah, sorry. I had to read this very important note.
I understand.
What is that? What's the number?
17.
All right. So, that's not... That's not... Yeah. Maybe?
Dude, holy smokes, dude. Got like a million HP.
Yep.
Okay.
It's being a fighter.
She kind of cackles
then
this time.
Zeros.
It's audible.
She's
not
telepathic
anymore. Yeah. She's like, all I needed was your life to free me from this place.
I go, okay, now you can help me. Okay, now you can come down.
What did she say?
She said that she's not good.
What did she say specifically?
She said, all I needed was your life to free me.
Yeah, I'm getting down there.
That's
amazing. If he says it, then I'm going to get down there.
Pull me out! Pull me out! Courtier mode. Pull me out!
I'm gonna help him.
Where is it? There it
is. I'm a little bit irritated with this lady, so I'm gonna drop down here.
Alright, you drop down there just in time to see her.
I cast block.
Attack.
I cast block.
No, I block it.
Okay.
We both.
You probably do. 24 to hit.
AC?
Yep.
It beats me.
They hit you?
Does it though? You're blessed though.
Blessed.
You're
doesn't
plus?
Do that.
No.
By how much? By how much?
Two.
Beat you by two.
Beat me by two. I have regular shield of faith. I don't have.
Shield. Yeah. Last time he had a shield off, but with shield of faith, honestly, run back to your shield total.
Can we do that?
Oh, I take that back. It beat me by four.
Cool.
Don't you have your shield out, or do you have Abigail? You took Abigail out
because
she's glowing. So.
I block
it. Block it.
You block it?
Yep. Yes, sir.
All right.
I accept.
So you're in
actually, I don't.
So you're down in there?
I'm just kidding.
Actually, I...
So you're down in there?
And
though?
I say, and then I say this.
Justice.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I do block it.
Justice.
I do block it.
And a slight tear comes to into my eye just before I get hit. I'm like, he's learning.
He's learning. It makes sense. I'm gonna cast shield on Flint.
Okay.
So what is she doing?
Actually, real quick, I guess this is gonna be important, Mike.
Is that alright, Mikey?
Can
Wraith being Wraith.
Can we
yeah, that's fine.
Can we occupy the same space or no? Cause I just dropped down, so that's important to know.
Well, no, you wouldn't be able to occupy the same space, no.
Okay, so Flint actually has to move, then?
But that's fine. That's why I was asking if... I mean, because you said hang on until she said that, right? Okay. Well, I mean, you can still cast shield on him if you can see him, though, right?
I mean, well, that's why I was going to ask, because
you'd be able to look down and see him. You'd be able to be above him, but it just drops down into the room.
Well, I guess what I'm saying is, if he can be in the same, if we can be in the same area, then this will work. If not, then it won't. I don't think.
Oh no! If the range itself, no, you couldn't cast something from.
Yeah.
So, is it the range? Is it range self?
Yes. Okay. That's why I was asking.
Yeah, that
on shield.
Yeah, I can't cast it on you.
Uh oh.
It would work if you had a halfling who was occupying your space, for example. But
you can't cast shield on somebody else.
No, it's a self spell.
All right.
That's why I thought we were gonna be able to. Cause I just dropped down.
Oh crap!
If I could.
No. 17 necrotic damage.
Well, I don't like it.
And then do a constitution saving throw for me.
Con save.
At least I stand a decent chance at this one. Depending on what that number is. What the heck was that?
Five?
That's 11.
Plus your d4.
So, do you think that'll be enough?
I don't know. I'm guessing it's a 15.
15?
What you got, 15.
Okay, I'll save, you're good.
Cool.
It's a good thing. This one's almost as dumb as yours. It's probably more dumb, actually, depending on how it works. All right.
No.
Flint. No, it can't be. This one can literally kill you.
Cool. Well, I'm gonna return a favor, I think.
Do your baddest for radiant damage then?
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do, some radiant damage.
Do you have a smite or something?
I do have a smite, actually.
Yeah, you should do some sort of smite.
You got like four smites.
I got a little bit of a smite. No big deal. Go ahead and smite. Hey, we look up sacred weapons for me to find out what it adds to my. I think it's my charisma plus something. Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna hit her with this hammer. And I'm going to say something like, you didn't have to be like this.
You're going to be like, hammer time.
Oh, it's a actual class thing.
Hammer time, justice, hammer time.
They don't call them MC. Right?
Sky's the limit.
Yeah.
Sky's the limit.
FM hammer.
Sacred weapon. As an action, you can imbue one of your weapons. 1 minute, you can add your charisma modifier to attack rolls made.
Macho Man coming for you.
Excellent. My charisma modifier is.
Yeah, no, we're coming for you.
Pretty decent.
Yeah.
Charisma modifier is. So I'm a little ticked off about this, about the whole, you know, hey, I came down here to help you, and then all of a sudden now you're like, I'm gonna get you bad. So I'm like, F you, lady. And, so yeah, sure. I'm gonna. Fair. Right?
That's
so
sense.
I'm gonna let Abigail whisper in her ear.
Abigail's gonna scream.
Yeah. And I'm gonna make this count, I believe. Rah! I'm gonna try to do as much damage as possible. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
Max out, dude, here we go.
I'm gonna flex on this lady.
That's a good idea.
Nat 20.
That'll be. Plus 3. That'll be 19.
That's a hit.
Okay, not bad.
So I'm gonna do that.
Smitification?
Thunderous Smite, we also looked that one up. Fine. I don't know, I can't remember if that's.
Is it a spell or is that a.
You have a Paladin Smite specific for you.
Yeah, I'm gonna use my spell slot to deal the radiant damage.
First time you hit with a melee attack during the spell duration.
What's the casting time?
Self one bonus action.
Okay.
Casting time.
So yeah, so as I'm coming in on this, I'm going to cast Thunderous Smite.
Okay.
And so just as I've kind of been hitting by this, I just kind of start whispering under my breath some of the ancient spells that I know in Celestial. And as I swing this, I'm gonna pound this lady's face into the ground because it's my first hit.
It's insubstantial.
It gives me. What's the plus to it? So that was my hit here. So yeah. Alright, we'll just start calculating this damage. Let's see. 2d6.
Not bad.
So, 10
what
there.
What was that for?
Yep.
What was that for? Your thunderous smite?
Yeah, what type?
That was the hammer.
That was just my hammer hit.
Okay.
Now I'm going to go with the 2d8 extra damage because she's undead. This is holy damage. 9.
And 2 more for the thunderous. 2d6 thunder damage. 9 on the thunder damage.
And it undoes my... It undoes this, because I've cast Thunder Smite.
28 so far.
Additionally, the target is... If the target is a creature... I'm assuming she's some sort of a creature. It must succeed on a strength saving throw. Or be pushed 10 feet away and knocked prone. I'm assuming if it can be knocked prone, I don't know that it can. I don't just... spitballing here. Dude, how about that, man? I'm just being like, dude, you're a frog.
No, you're a frog.
No, guys, you guys get it. I don't want that thing on me.
Get it? What? I'm not saying I'm scared. I'm just like,
I'm not.
It's just weird.
Afraid of it.
Okay, so it slides back into this corner. Remains floating.
All right. As she push?
So 10.
Yeah, she slides back into the corner.
19.
Okay.
28. 34. Damage. Via magical weapon.
How did you... Wait. You did the radiant?
9 is radiant.
Yeah, you did 10 and 9.
And an additional 6 from just my weapon plus.
Okay.
28 that's blood max in. Without the extra radiant.
Except for the thunder damage, which was 9 thunder damage.
Yeah, 9 of it was thunder, if that matters.
It does matter.
Sweet.
Because that was 4 thunder damage. Okay. Anything else?
Yeah, I'm going to do it again.
Okay.
So as I hit her,
good idea.
She slams up into the wall. I'm going to run up again, crunch her again. And this will cost me...
my life.
Only that. Only that. Thunderous Smite is gone, because it's only the first time that I hit with that attack. Oops.
Did she hit you for some damage? How bad?
Yeah, she got me. She did 17 damage.
Okay.
First time you hit with the melee attack during the spell's duration. So that was super loud.
Yeah. Audible 300.
Yeah. So I won't get that.
Super loud.
So I just run up on her again and just kind of crunch, try to crunch her.
Alright, so you're moving up this way now?
Yep.
Okay. Crunch some numbers.
Crunch an inspiration, dude.
Much better.
Yeah. That'll be 21. That's, yeah. 24.
I'm 19 hit. Yeah.
7 radiant. Yeah, 1s and 2s.
Better.
7 radiant, 7 normal, and 6 normal.
So 13 normal, 7 radiant.
20 total?
Yep.
Okay.
20 total, but 7 of it was
7
radiant.
Of it's radiant.
Okay. Some glares in here, the mess that are making glare.
Yeah.
She doesn't realize how it's not as effective.
Oh, she look wounded? Hurt?
Looks like a floating wraith.
Looks not at all.
She's wounded and hurt.
I mean, he knows he made solid contact. That's, I mean, like, no doubt about that.
So. Then, with that, as I see that she's not yet destroyed, I'm going to let Abigail slide down so that the mallet is just above my right hand, and I'm going to draw my shield back out.
Okay. Shell.
That's me, man.
Flint disappeared from underneath you. There was noises.
Well, there was more than a noise. The ground probably
this room with bright light.
Yeah, I say the ground probably shook a little bit.
I'm saying you're looking down in a hole. He ran out from under the hole, and there was noises. There was noise, big noise, obviously. And then he ran somewhere chasing.
So I'm dropping in now, right now.
Whoop.
Yeah. So I mean, you clearly see. I'm saying you were standing above in the other room.
I cast phone call.
Phone call?
And I call Kakashi.
Hello. I'm just kidding.
He's on a mission right now.
Dang it, man!
Voicemail.
Alright, dang it, that sucks.
Something like that.
Oh, you have a reach a Kakashi. Leave a message for Kakashi Sensei. I shall return shortly.
Wow.
This is ridiculous. Forget it. You'll never be the white thing. No, I'm just kidding. I wouldn't say that to him. That's mean.
He doesn't want anything. He's his own guy. Nailed it. Concussion? Not concussion. No, it's not even close. I mean, it's pretty close.
So this is the Wraith that cursed me.
Yeah.
Or was responsible for it.
Yeah. You can tell this is clearly the real team and the other one's not a real team.
Oh, surprise, surprise. Yeah, I figured that out when you said that.
Yeah. I'm just saying now that your character's in your
shot. Alright, attacker.
That's what I would do.
You know what I do?
Attack.
I'm leading against this wall.
Very effective
strategy. No, I'm just kidding.
Works well for me.
I'm actually going to...
sure, you didn't die.
I'm going to throw a magic missile at this lady's nose.
Away, so.
All right.
So I'm actually going to pull one off and toss it. So let's do that, Mike. What do you think?
Off your necklace?
He has yes. He has disadvantage. Obviously.
How does that make sense?
Wait, you want this one?
Give me that one, baby. Lance, how many you got?
Two.
Throw them here. Let's see. It's three. Is it three for the normal one?
Oh, it's four.
Is it four? For
no, it is three. It's three.
Yeah. Two. Four. I need one more. Mike, you got one more?
We D4? We need D4?
D4?
Absolutely.
Alright, here
you go. What are the point you want?
You got those smoky white ones, dude. You using this?
Yeah.
That one's guaranteed 4, dude.
Is it?
Don't stab your hand.
One.
I know, it feels like it.
Danny sucked.
Oh.
But
alright.
The other two are 4.
Yeah, so. No, 3 or 4.
12. Okay, so 12, 14, 16, 18, 19, plus
7,
26.
Side note, nobody's blessed anymore.
Oh, no.
26?
So now that I realize that I'm not blessed and I'm cursed, I'm just sad.
No longer cancels out.
So. You go like this. You just go.
Okay.
Sorry, I just realized that. Also, I used Thunderous Smite that broke my concentration.
Also, side note, that was force damage.
Yeah. I don't know that. Pretty sure force damage is just force damage. I mean, there's very few things that have resistance to force damage.
It's the least resisted thing in the monster manual.
Yeah.
Which is, I think, on purpose. So.
Yeah.
So.
Deal with it, sucker!
Well, I mean, it just makes sense, though. Because you use magic to resist, and it is magic, so. All right. Roll.
Jock coming for you. Yeah.
Roll percentile dice for me, real quick.
These make
obvious contact. They hit the Wraith for sure. One after the other. Tell me.
How's a 50? 50 straight, boy.
You have 50 or you have 5? You sure 50?
Fire is always better.
Yeah.
Yeah, but except for last time.
When it was just a... Well, I mean, it didn't do anything bad.
I told you.
It just like made this frog.
It made a flying frog. That's super cool.
Flying frog.
It's on you. It's on you, dude. I called the last one.
It's got to be on the dice, dude.
On the dice.
Top half, top number. What just happened?
Okay, 50.
50?
50.
50.
50. 50. I don't want that responsibility.
What?
Okay.
Shaw, coming for you.
You can't speak for the next minute.
Okay.
If you attempt to, pink bubbles come out of your mouth this time.
That's so cool. That's so much cooler than you were before. It's like.
But.
No, well.
So, your magic missiles, you can probably deduce that the fact that you were able to take it from another magical item caused that to be more effective than your previous spell, but also
I was kind of hoping that
there
was
a second effect. So
that's fine. I was just hoping that was going to be better than the last time. I was like this. I cast nothing.
Yeah.
I think you mean.
Okay. And at that point, the Wraith, this particular Wraith,
explodes.
Very similar situation to the first two, which you didn't see, but what Flint did see, minus the glowing, like the light. the first two had, this one kind of just slowly sinks back into the tomb, into the sarcophagus.
Do I know that I need to, like, salt and burn the bones and crap? Is that a thing?
No. You could do...
religion check?
You could do an arcana check or a religion check. Either
religion-y.
Sure. You both do, and you're both down here.
11.
27. Doesn't matter. That'd be great, though.
Flint, you're not... You don't really... No. I mean, there's not really anything you deduce any further from that. Shaw, you know that... Something pretty powerful would be required to awaken stuff like this. And you, the more you think about it, the more you know that this is a very ancient civilization that's depicted here.
Mm-hmm.
And this people have no doubt been dead for like eons. So something fishy is going on. These people would not just...
Would you say maybe there's something strange in our neighborhood?
Something similar to that?
In this neighborhood?
It's not really your neighborhood, though.
Well...
A neighborhood. Mm-hmm. Well, not be racist.
The four of us.
That guy.
You guys.
But this is my hood.
Right.
Then yes, there's something strange in the neighborhood.
I'm still Flint from the block.
See?
But they used to call me Flinty.
Now there's new kids on the block.
I'm still Flinty from the block.
They used to call me Flinty, bro.
But you left, now there's new kids on the block.
Oh, no.
And
I'm not fighting.
And there's a gang war between
Marky
those.
Marks, brother.
There's a gang war going on between the new kids on the block that replace you and some guy, some boys that live on the back street.
Oh no.
It's getting pretty serious. All right.
Here's the thing, dude. We need to get in sync and,
is it really that
and
late
take
already?
These guys out.
All right.
Turn these boys into men.
Oh, you too.
Boys to men, son.
Hey, BC, BBD.
And make, all right, and make Spears, Brittany, Brunheim. No,
right, stop. Moving on. That's over, I guess. All right.
Is there anything that can help me get rid of this curse of some kind?
Yeah.
That's what I'm after.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because I done got cursified, and I'm hoping with the 27 I can be uncursified.
Lay it back down. It's gone. You feel it.
It's gone?
Whew. Yeah. Wild magic still there? Boom, boom, boom.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Your magic, you know your magic is basically still broken, but the curse is for sure gone.
Okay, well that's helpful.
I think maybe you should be more worried about the fact that your magic's broken.
It's just this area.
Okay.
I shoot some sort of weirdness.
I take
in
my
this
bow
area,
out and I shoot
like some sort of ward where it's
I
like
think one
specifically to
poison
Shaw.
Or disease.
It's still glowing.
I don't think
there
anything
Abigail's.
As far as like a magic.
Well, I know. I shoot an arrow down there. And it's the messengers.
Okay.
And Shaw, you.
An arrow lands next to you. A magical looking arrow lands next to you.
And
I close my eyes.
Is everything alright?
You hear that.
Who did this?
Me. You see an arrow hitting the floor next to you. You hear, is it alright? Is everything alright?
Oh.
Why didn't you
take it up three notches?
I had my back.
What?
I had my back. Two.
Three more arrows.
I don't know why this happened. So yeah, when I hear that, I turn around and I'm like, yeah, we're good. And I'm like, where you're sitting here paying attention to this, but you didn't say anything? It's like, the fuck is that? I'm like, healing check.
I do this.
This guy's got a demon. I know that this guy is not.
I go
is
like
not
this.
Sick
I go
anymore.
Like this. And it just says it's magic.
You could send a message, can you?
I got magicked. That's what I say.
Or
I got magicked.
Yeah, magic.
You
and
have
I'm
to
like,
speak.
I understand. I've also been magicked myself.
All right, keeper of the XP. Yeah.
Would
you?
If you message
650 additional XP.
650.
Yes.
I'm gonna push the lid off this thing.
What?
Okay.
And see if she's got any sweet loot.
Yeah, we need some loot, dude.
So it's a thin gold sheath that's actually covering the whole sarcophagus. You can just peel that
real
right
quick,
off if you want.
When he
to.
Does this, when he does this, I'm standing over here with counterspell ready.
Okay. Do you are you just trying to open it, or are you? So basically, The way this sarcophagus is,
I hang down from the ceiling.
Make sure I tell you right.
And look at him.
I cast reverse gravity on this thing.
This has gold inlay on top of it.
I float up.
And then there's a stone chest over against over to, at the end of it, which if you try to is unlocked.
We don't have any rogue anymore.
It's unlocked.
If, oh, cool. If I see if I see him doing a treasure, I go
treasure.
Just like that.
All right.
And if anybody's ever played the game Overlord, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, go check it out.
Okay.
Any sweet loot?
In the stone chest, you find 4,000 silver pieces.
Mine.
1,200 gold pieces. Mine. 11 zircons, which are worth 50 gold pieces.
I should write this down.
Yeah, that's right. Should write all this down.
Mm-hmm. Start back from the top.
So 4,000 silver pieces, 1,200 gold pieces.
That's terrible.
11 zircon, which are worth 50 gold pieces.
I love being
each.
In the Underdark and I'm being
so,
50 each.
So 550 total value of zircons.
So we got 1,400 silver?
Yeah.
4,000 silver, 1,200 gold.
Yeah. Yeah.
You find a necklace and a couple of potions.
The necklace? Do we know what the necklace does?
You can kind of identify it. I can't check. It's a kind of a medium-sized chain with a pendant on it that has flames engraved on it.
I'll identify it. I'll actually cast identify as ritual.
I mean, you can just if you guys are in a rush, you can
if
identify.
It's like the one of like plus defense.
It's a necklace of fireballs.
Fireballs.
And you're able to determine. I assume you're gonna try to identify the liquids as well.
I can identify the liquids.
No. Well, this one was invisibility.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
As I'm hanging from the
ceiling, identify all
these. So is Titan going to? Is that are you gonna do that?
As I'm hanging, I'll do it. Okay. Easy.
As I'm hanging from the ceiling, do I see
we've had too many surprises.
You identify one as a potion of greater healing, and one as a filter of love.
Potion of
you might want
potion of healing.
Greater healing.
Greater.
And then a filter of love, which you will need for your drill girlfriend.
Yes.
Yeah, I wouldn't need it.
Hey, I know you want to fight me, but drink this first, and then we'll fight.
As I'm suspended and hanging
all of this stuff.
No, how many gold? 1,200 gold?
1,200 gold pieces, 4,000 silver pieces. Are you guys trying to pry the gold?
Is that 400?
Are you trying, what? No, that's
silver.
And then what's the 550?
400 gold?
Yeah, you take 10 off, so 400 gold if you do that.
As I'm hanging from the ceiling, do I see all this treasure?
1,200 gold. Gold.
He's getting it out of a stone chest. Oh, okay. You have to be down there to really see it. Do you guys try to peel the gold?
I do flip down.
Film off of the sarcophagus?
Dude, I bet she's got crap in there with her. On that crusty old body she got in there.
You guys opening it?
That's pretty disrespectful.
Do a strength check for me.
Hey, F her.
Oh, wow.
Killing us is also disrespectful.
Yeah. And I was like, I was all coming down here, and I was like, hey, I'm not going to attack you right off the bat. I'm going to give you a chance to explain what you need. That's you're attacking me. That's cool. Yes, excellent.
Oh, man, you forced my hand. Also, with the necklace fireballs, how many stones are in it?
Oh, there's a single stone.
Just one stone?
This particular one, it's... it's.
Or is there like a deep... isn't there like a roll table on there?
It's a very ornate... and then it comes down with these carvings, and then what seems to be a large stone in the center.
Identification spell.
I ask him, power is it?
Is it an athletics check or just pure strength?
Oh, fire.
Strength check.
Then I got an 8.
Fireball?
8 total?
Yes.
Is anybody assisting?
Can you cast that?
If I'm struggling, I'll be like, Titan, I need your help.
I'm mage handing the crap out of this.
All right. I'm
no, I don't. If Titan's coming over.
Both of you do another strength check together then.
Check.
This was actually harder than not.
12.
Never mind. 20. You got it.
I rolled 13, so 11.
Hey, that's why I asked for help.
So once again, Runeheim's about to come start pushing on it, and you guys are like, I was going to get that.
Something was weird.
So, all right. So. When you open it up,
I was gonna get that.
You see a mummified corpse grasping a sword. Top of body, and that's all you see is the remains grasping the sword.
You have just
Whoa!
The sword.
Give me the crap out of that sword.
The sword looks as if though it was just crafted and polished.
Just crafted?
I mean,
do I immediately recognize it as a paladin sword of legend?
Yes. Do I really?
Really?
Do a religion check for me.
Dude, that's sick.
You can't be real.
20.
10?
10? That's all you needed.
Cool. Ew.
This is Dawnbringer.
Dawnbringer?
You know
what's that? Actually, I probably would know.
Holy weapon, and you also know it's a sentient weapon.
Sentient.
It's intelligent. It can talk.
It's
got a mind of its own.
I thought it meant it was really shiny.
I sheath Abigail.
Yeah, that's basically
common misconception.
I sheath Abigail and I go. I believe I recognize this sword, but I've been wrong about magic related things before. I'm gonna grab this and.
If I die,
you want me
to
identify it beforehand?
No. If I do something weird, you might have to attack me, and then I grab it.
He starts off with, if I do something weird, cut me down.
Guys, just...
I mean, we could have just circumvented the whole thing.
Done. I get my maul to the river.
Yeah, and I count. It's like, okay, I'll be diplomatic about it.
I'll help you out.
I hit him with another magic miss.
I'll just break your arm so you
can. I'm not even doing anything weird. What are you guys doing?
Let me do it first.
Yeah, so very delicately, I grab it from her.
So I'm trying to find it.
Adam wants to, like, then spit upon her, but I won't. That's Flint. So that's not something that he would do.
And I look at him, and I'm like, do you feel alright?
The magic of Dawnbreaker.
I look at you, and I'm like, do you feel alright? He's cursed.
I just looked at this before, because I was like, this could be important.
He's lost speech.
Blah, 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 blah.
Sean, what do you say?
Well, it's probably already gone.
Yeah, it only lasted for a minute. You're good now.
So, okay.
Unless all this was happening.
I missed the bubbles.
Super
excited. Yeah. Okay, so what was our total goal here?
So we're at 1750. And then we're going to condense the silver, right?
Yeah, into gold. Or not, I guess. We can start collecting silver, too.
2150.
I've got a gap between gold and electrum.
2150.
So is it 40 gold or 40 silver?
Do 2150 divided by.
Oh yeah, I forgot about electrum. I forget about that. It's in the middle, isn't it?
No.
If that's the case, it would be 40 gold. That seems kind of useless. That 4,000 silver pieces, when you just carry 40 pieces of gold.
Yeah, but I mean, it depends on how well you break it down. If you're like, oh, it's 2 silver to stay in an inn for a night, then it's really good.
537.
I know, but I'm saying if you're finding it, that's what I'm saying. It is electrums between silver and gold, so that would make the silver pieces even lower on the value. So it would be 40 gold.
That.
So that's what we were getting at.
Yeah. Okay. So it's 1750 gold divided by 4.
537. It's 2150, right?
No, we were just talking about that silver. There's a gap between silver and gold now, and
because
it's
electrum.
So it's actually 10% instead of.
No, it's 1%.
Yeah, it's 1%. I was like, wait a minute.
It was 40?
That's stupid.
40. I suck at math in general.
It's like terrible.
Yeah, it's 40. But we'll just call it 2,000 gold. Or 4,000 gold. So everybody gets 1,000 silver.
I thought Electrum was almost like. Just
everybody gets
like
an extra 10 gold from that.
But it didn't actually dilute.
Everybody gets an extra 10 gold.
Yeah, I don't know that it does. I think you're right. Thanks.
What is it?
Well, I thought Electrum was just kind of stuck in there, but it didn't, like, change the value of silver to gold.
It's half.
Yeah, it doesn't.
It's half of gold.
Oh, okay, so it's still 10.
It's
so,
still 10.
Either way, I'm still going to just list mine as 1,000 silver.
So everybody
I'm going to do 537, because that's what it breaks down to. 2150.
Oh, 537 gold?
537
How much gold do you guys have?
537. I haven't added in my gold. I don't have any gold.
Yeah, yeah, yours is it. Yeah, yours is it. You got that one. Super scroll.
I now have 537.
That's your total?
And 357.
It's not really useful right now. So.
Because I had spent a whole bunch on something.
I'm just going to say
I don't remember.
537, huh? Yeah, really, let's be honest. Like, none of it's useful at the moment. Like, we're all stuck. We're in a freaking cave.
Yeah, I mean,
until we find a random vendor that's just hanging out.
Hey, what's up, man? You want to buy some stuff?
You want to buy some dust sticks?
Let's go to let's go to the Dark Elves and see if they want to trade.
That's exactly right, dude. You can buy some dust sticks.
Well, let's see if the Dark Elves want to trade some stuff.
I want Mike to figure out how to put Dawnbreaker's magic on Abigail. Abigail, the Dawnbreaker.
Dawnbringer.
Oh, it's called the Dawnbringer? Yes. Excellent. Mine's going to be called Dawnbreaker. It's a hammer.
Doesn't make sense.
Dawnbreaker, dude. Breaks the dawn.
I used to bring dawn, but now I break it.
Dawn. Daybreak. Dawnbreak. Break it.
The it's break.
Hammer time.
I'll hit him like this.
All right, guys. We're just going to wrap up from here. Split some loot. Junk like that. You know, the boring stuff. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll be back next week. Also, exciting news. We're going to be doing daily gameplays.
Yes, that's almost
daily. We're starting a full-on weekly schedule where we will not be playing on Sundays. It's the Lord's Day, so we give it to him. But we are going to be, each of us is going to play a separate day of the week, so we will be with you always.
Sorry. Wow.
I shouldn't do this late at night. Anyway, thanks for tuning in. Make sure you subscribe, follow, like, and all that stuff. We'll see you next time at the table.
At the table, huh? That's pretty cool.
I'm working on it.
Not bad.